Asante Gold's announced it's forming a 50-50 joint venture with BXC Company to develop the Kubi mining leases in Ghana toward production. I'm joined on the line now by Chief Executive Doug MacQuarrie. Doug, good to speak to you. Tell me first of all a little bit more about the deal.
Likewise, Andrew. The deal is pretty straightforward. We've been looking for a partner to get Kubi in production for the last couple of years, and I think we found the right partner in BXC. BXC's been active in Ghana for 10 years. They're primarily involved in power infrastructure, and they've recently ventured out into the gold mining sector, and I think they realize that with Asante, they pick up a heck of a lot of expertise, country knowledge, and of course access to our Kubi project.
Well, they're a big company too, listed in China, market cap of, what, 580 million?
Yeah, that's right, and so certainly they're very market smart, and I think that's the key reason why, besides funding roughly $15 million into the project, they also thought it absolutely key that they took a 30% equity position in the company. And I think they're very interested in growing the gold assets in Ghana, both on the Kubi, putting Kubi into production as a 500 ton per day underground mine, but keeping upside should Asante lock into, say, a larger project through its ongoing exploration efforts.
Well, you say you think you've found the right partner. Shares rocketed 30% on the back of this news, so investors clearly welcoming it.
Yes, well, our market's still pretty thin, so that's something we'll be developing over the next, hopefully, 6 months, is to increase the liquidity, make it a little easier for some of the larger institutions to get involved. We don't have any institutional investors at all at the moment, so that'll be something we're focusing on in the next few months.
Certainly, and you've agreed to pay, is it the two underlying Kubi royalties from your share of the joint venture revenue?
Well, yeah, that was you know, just basically a negotiated point on doing the deal. We were able to reduce the underlying royalty from Gocnet from a 2% to a 1%, so essentially that didn't change the deal at all from original perspective of Asante only 100% paying 2% or only 50% and paying 1%. So it really didn't change the terms that much at all.
I know you touched on it earlier, but it would be good to know just a little bit more about where you're looking to spend some of this cash that you've raised in the joint venture.
Right. So it's all subject to closing. So we're going to hopefully have the closing at the AGM December 28th in Vancouver, where we get the shareholder approval of the acquisition of the Kubi property. We can then close on the BXC deal. Essentially, the $15 million will be applied to some surface works, getting power in, start the portal, and start driving the decline, underground development. So it's about a 12-month funding, and that'll basically bring us to the point of having initial test shipments of ore from the mine.
Very good, Doug. Just while we've got you, how are things at Asante? I mean, what's the plan going forward for the next couple of months?
Okay, so basically, you know, as I say, I think we've got the right partner. We certainly got in Asante the right people. We've got the former PMI management team, which I was the former CEO. We've got the former mine manager of Obuasi, who's was underground at Obuasi for 30 years with crews of up to 1,000 people. So I think we got all everything we need to get Kubi going, funding and people. So that pretty well frees up Asante to explore aggressively to find the next big one in Ghana.
Really good to speak to you, Doug, as always. Thanks for the time.
Thank you, Andrew. Have a good one.